Good morning, everyone. Today we're going to have geometric sequence, and this is your Sir Topper at your service. Let's have this connecting to real life. Chain text messages operate the same way as chain letters. One such chain text requires the recipient to send the message to other three people within hour. So you are going to have this, you're given the time, 7 a.m., 8 a.m., 9 a.m., and the number of text recipients every hour. For 7 a.m., we have 1, for 8 a.m., we have 3, and for 9 a.m., we have 9. So with this, we can have it, the summary in a table. We have the number of recipients and the time. 7 a.m., 8 a.m., 9 a.m., 10 a.m. So as you can see, 7 a.m. is 1, 8 a.m. is 3, 9 a.m. is 9, and 10 a.m. is 27. What would be the number of recipients in 11 a.m.? Like the arithmetic sequence, each of the terms in a geometric sequence is related in one way or another to the preceding term. So let's have the definition of geometric sequence. Geometric sequence is a sequence in which each term is obtained by multiplying the preceding term by a common number called constant, and this is named as common ratio with a symbol of R. So let's have common ratio. What is this? The common ratio is obtained by dividing any term by the preceding term. Let us have this example. 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64. Okay. So we need to apply this simple formula. The second term must be divided with the first term, which is 4 over 2, and it is equal to 2. And also we can have the fourth term divided by the third term. So we have 16 over 8 with a quotient of 2. And also we can have the sixth term divided by the fifth term. So 64 divided by 32 is 2. As you can see, we have the same quotient, and that is called common ratio on the given example. Okay. Common ratio and the nth term in a geometric sequence. Let's have the concept. The nth term of the geometric sequence is a sub n equals a sub 1 times r raised to n minus 1, where a sub 1 is the first term, a sub n is the last term, n is the number of terms, and r is the constant ratio. Let's have example A. Find the third term of the geometric sequence 2, 4, 8. First, let us show the given a sub 1 is 2, r is 2, n is 10. How do we get r? Just simply divide 4 by 2 or 8 by 4, which is equal to 2. That's the formula. A sub n is equal to a sub 1 times r raised to n minus 1. And by substitution, we have a sub 10 equals 2 times 2 raised to 10 minus 1. This is simple manipulation by substitution. To simplify further, a sub 10 is 2 times 2 raised to 9, wherein when we simplify everything on the right side, a sub 10 is equal to 1024, and that is the 10th term of 2, 4, 8. And again, 2, 4, 8 is in the geometric sequence. Let's have example B. Find R in the geometric sequence if the first term is 1/3 and the 8th term is 128 over 3. Let's have the given A sub 1 is 1 third. A sub 8 is 128 over 3. And your n is 8. And you are looking for the r. So we're going to use the basic formula for geometric sequence. A sub n is equal to a sub 1 times r raised to n minus 1. And by substitution, we have 128 over 3 equals 1 third times r, which is the unknown, raised to 8 minus 1. This is purely substitution. And to simplify further, we have 128 over 3 on the left equals 1 third times r raised to 7. Raised to 7, okay, that is r. We need to solve for the value of r itself. So we can have the expression, the so-called exponential expression. So r sub 7, r raised to 7 is 128, wherein 128 is equal to exponential expression as 2 raised to 7. What did you notice? They have the same exponent. So all you need to do is copy the base. So therefore, r is equal to 2, and that is called the constant ratio. Let's have example C. What term is 2916 in geometric sequence 4, 12, 36? Let's have the given. Obviously, a sub 1 is 4. R is 3, the constant ratio, and a sub n is 2916. And using the formula and by substitution, we have 2916 equals 4 times 3 raised to n minus 1. So to simplify further, divide the equation by 4. So we have 2916 divided by 4 is 729. Okay? And express 729 in base 3 to have the same base on the right side. If they have the same base, just copy the exponent. So 6 equals n minus 1 and solve for n. So n is 7. Therefore, we conclude that 2916 is the seventh term of the given geometric sequence 4, 12, 36. Let's have example D. Find the first three terms of a geometric sequence whose sum is 42 and whose product is 512. Let the first three terms of the geometric sequence as A over R, A and A times R, or AR. So, equate them into 512 as the product. So, we have A cubed equals 512. And let us solve for A. So, A is equal to 8. So, simply multiply all the A's on the numerator. So, we have A cubed. And the R on the denominator, and another r and the numerator will be cancelled out. So we left with a cube. Then express 512 in base a to have the same exponent. So a cube is simply equal to 512. So therefore a is equal to 8. And let us take the other one. Geometric sequence whose sum is 42. When you say sum, it is addition. So we need to add the three geometric sequence. So A over R plus A plus AR is 42. By simple manipulation, by addition, so we have this one. So by substitution, if A is 8, so 8 over R plus 8 R equals 42. Then 8 plus 8R plus 8R squared is equal to 42 times R. Why? Simply clear the left side by removing the denominator R. So by multiplying both sides by R. So we have 8 over r will be 8. The next one is 8 times r. And this, the third one is 8r times r, which is 8r squared. You must also do that in your right side. So we have 42r. And let's simplify further by combining like terms. So we have 8r squared plus 8r minus 42r plus 8 was 0. To simplify further, we have 8r squared minus 34r plus 8. So simply 8r minus 42r is negative 34r. Okay, reduce. So we have divided by 2. We have 8 by 2 is 4. 34 by 2 is 17. 8 by 2 is 4. So we have the new equation, 4r squared minus 17r plus 4 equals 0. And by factoring, we have 4r minus 1 times r minus 4 equals 0. Let us check. Let's use the first one. 4r minus 1 equals 0. To solve for r, we have r equals 1/4. If we are going to use r equals 1/4, then the three terms are 32, 8, and 2. Let's have the second factor, r minus 4 equals 0. In here, r is equal to 4. Therefore, the three terms, if we're going to use r as 4, we have 2, 8, and 32. Okay, clear? So let's have skills enhancement. Find the 10th term of the sequence 1000, negative 500, 250, negative 125. Next, the third term of the geometric sequence is 144, and the sixth term is 486. Find the first term of the geometric sequence. And lastly, let's have this sheet work. Write the first five terms of the geometric sequence, whose first term is 2 and whose common ratio is 3. Find the 10th term of the geometric sequence, negative 2, negative 6, negative 18. And lastly, find the 14th term of the geometric sequence. Okay, that's all guys for the day. And this is Sir Topper. Thank you for listening.